students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding watch the follow through written by Rakesh Sood. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now what is the essence of this editorial? The essence of this editorial is about the increasing relevancy of Iran in the world diplomacy. Now the another essence of this editorial is how Iran is becoming favorite for everybody, and there is a race that is about to take place in order to engage Iran. So in order to yield substantive benefits out of it, a country like India must really up its ante if it wants to derive benefits out of Iran. Now, in order to understand how Iran has become certainly so important for the world, what are the reasons behind it? Now, the relevancy of Iran has increased in the global diplomacy because the relevancy of Saudi Arabia has declined, because the relevancy of Israel vis-a-vis Iran has declined. Now Iran has also gained more relevancy because of the rising specter of ISIS. Now the specter of ISIS is looming really large. Now when it is looming large, there is a building consensus world over for taming of this ISIS, and how this ISIS can be tamed. Now this ISIS can be tamed if the world will align behind the Shia countries, and the leader of the Shia countries is Iran. Now we also need to understand why this ISIS specter, it has grown to a level from a very timid stage. Now it has grown large from a timid state because this entire ISIS was fueled, this entire ISIS was burgeoned, this entire ISIS was inflated by the intricate interests of the Sunni world. Now the Sunni world is having indirect benefits laced in the strengthening of ISIS, because this ISIS has a goal to establish the Sunni caliphate. Now because it has a goal to establish Sunni caliphate, it will be acting against the Shia forces. And when it comes to the countries of the Middle East, they don't have a very broad horizon. They don't have a very broad vision. They don't have any big idea of the world. Their goals are actually very myopic. Their goals are very short. Now when you compare all the countries of the world, the Western countries specifically, especially United States of America, it always had and has very far goals. And second to the hierarchy is the European countries. Now these countries too have a very broad vision about the world. But when it comes to the Middle East countries, the Asian countries, the Southeast Asian countries, their vision is quite myopic. Their vision is myopic because they lack in the resources of how to control this world. Now it is because of this myopic vision, this Shia world is fighting with the Sunni world. And in this intricate equation of Shia versus the Sunni, the Shia world, it had gained a lot of prominence. Iran has gained a lot of prominence. Now Iran is having a good relationship with Russia. Iran is having good relationship with China. Of late, there has been a rapprochement between Iran and United States of America. And with respect to Middle East, the declining relevancy of Saudi Arabia. Now, how can we say that the Saudi Arabia's relevancy has decreased? Now, it has decreased because United States of America's interests have actually shrunk in Saudi Arabia. United States of America is no longer interested in the energy resources of Saudi Arabia. And it is because of that, United States of America has not supported the interests of Saudi Arabia in Yemen. It has not supported the interests of Saudi Arabia in Syria. It has not supported the interests of Saudi Arabia in Egypt. Now, United States of America has sidelined the interests of Saudi Arabia with respect to these countries. And it is taking the steps which are more in favor of Iran. So the balance of power that had tilted in favor of the Sunni world after the Iranian revolution of 1979, it had shifted. Now the pendulum has moved more towards the Shia world. Shia world's prominence, Shia world's bonhomie, Shia world's rapprochement is making it a boy to be loved by everyone. So in such a situation, a country like India, it is facing a problem of how to engage deeply with Iran. And how can that be done? That can be done if we will concretize and implement the Chabahar port at the earliest. It will happen if we will participate, if we will collaborate, if we will cooperate, if we will coordinate with Iran in exploring its oil fields. It will happen if India will be consistent in its approach to support Iran. It will happen if India indirectly will become party to fight against ISIS forces. It will happen if India will take a balanced view with respect to the Shia and the Sunni world. It will happen if India will not blindly support Saudi Arabia, but will base its decision on the basis of rationality and equanimity. So this was all for the editorial. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes, please visit our website brainyias.com. In case you have any sort of query, you can contact me at 845-94-0000. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.